you at the outset. I am indeed privileged to be here, and I am very thankful to Manthan for considering NIOS as one of the finalists. I am representing National Institute of Open Schooling, NIOS, which is it's an autonomous organization of the Ministry of HRD, and we are providing school-level education and various vocational education through distance, open and distance learning. Since we have the face-to-face contact is very limited in our open learning system, so we are forced and compelled to use all sorts of ICT to reach out our learners. So I'll be presenting through some of our slides here. We are considered to be the largest open schooling in the world. In terms of enrollment, if you look at here, we have 2.2 million learners with us, and we call it cumulative enrollment is last five years enrollments. And annual intake is about 500,000, 5 lakhs learners are associated with NIOS. And then we are also geographically spread all over India. We also have some study centers outside in Nepal, UAE. And we also given a certification of about 2 million learners as of date since our beginning when we started at 1989. What are the instructional system? Maybe the same as for the other educational system also, but for open learning system, what is very prime, what is very important is the learner. We keep our learner at the center of the entire system, and then we develop the entire project for NIOS for open learning system. So we identify the needs of the groups, then the curriculum is developed, then the material is developed, then the delivery is done to the learners, and then evaluation takes place. Any feedback, it goes again to the development of curriculum. Some of the hallmarks, which are very different from the formal systems and which enables many of the learners, particularly learners from the disabled group also, and from slow learners, for them, it's a boon kind of thing. Also, for many other people who are not able to, for various reasons, not able to go to school, not able to attend the schools, is a boon for NIOS is providing all kinds of services. So there is no upper age limit and self-certification. Even if you have not done any schooling, you can join NIOS secondary level and you can appear in the examination. You can become a secondary level, senior secondary level graduate. And the other is, I can tell you, the motivation comes that even we have 71 years old learners who are doing their secondary and senior secondary sitting at the remotest corner of the village, where we are trying to reach through our common service center using this ICT services. Freedom to choose the subjects. How? I mean, for formal system, unless you pass in mathematics, you cannot become a secondary level. We have a list of subjects where you have to choose 5 subjects. One subject should be language, that's all, and then you choose the subjects as per your interest and your wish. Need-based vocational education and its integration with our academic courses is also one of a very important aspect of NIOS. How we, the comprehensive and continuous evaluation is through our tutor mark assignments. Credit accumulation. You don't have to pass all 5 subjects in one go. You appear in one subject, it goes into your credit. And credit accumulation is one of a scientific way of evaluation which NIOS is doing here. Learning support through personal contact programs. Some of the contact programs are also learned where the students come and face-to-face interaction is done with the teachers. Provision of readmission. If you are not able to complete your course within 5 years, then you can readmit, and whatever you have already acquired will transfer into your new enrollment. Facility of transfer of credit up to 2 subjects from other boards. If you are a failure, then you are most welcome to join NIOS, and with the previous board, if you have passed 2 subjects, that subjects will be transferred with NIOS. NIOS online, we started to help out the learners because face-to-face contact was very limited, and unless we tap this ICT, we cannot reach out to our learners. and particularly with accessibility for the learners, disabled for the learners, we had to keep in our mind to make our entire online project, entire online applications, so that they can also access to it. This is our website, which has various characteristics with this. Bilingual and compatible on any of the browser. It is independent of browsers, user-friendly, especially learners with disability and with easy navigations. Screen reader access, text size, all these have been taken into consideration to help out the learners who are in the disabled category. Though it also improves the navigation for all kinds of learners and users. It meets the guidelines of Indian government website and adhere to web content accessibility guidelines. That's the very important part. We keep this guidelines into mind while developing our website and while providing all kinds of online services. This has given us, we also have been selected in the National Award for Empowerment of Persons with Disability 2012 as Best Accessible Website under Government Websites. We also have been awarded by NCPEDP Emphasis Universal Design Award 2012. What are the information and services we are trying to provide? In our case, all admissions are 100% online. And in the online admission, it's very simple. Looking at the target group of our learners, it has to be very convenient, very user-friendly, and very simple. So what are the steps? Very easy steps. Register, fill the form, make the online payment, and submit. Your admission is done. This is how we try to make everything very simple. Then after admission, they get their course material. Though we send them all the print material to all their learners, but all our course materials are also available on our website, entire secondary, senior secondary, every course material, which the learners, the day they enter into our courses, they start accessing our course material also. And then the course material are also under schedule of personal contact programs, where they are allotted a study center where they have to come and interact with the tutors, and all schedules which is given to them online as well as it is also given to them on their mobile phones. And as per their subjects, they attend the contact classes to the study centers. After that, many of the resources, educational resources, we are also opening this open educational resources where entire course materials are available as well as course materials are available open for public also. They can also contribute into it, even the learners can also contribute into it, and it's an open platform where the course materials are available from NIOS side. And presently we have started three vocational courses with online admission, and we are using the open platform of Moodle to register the learner under these three vocational courses. That is ICT application, then we have a rural technology, and then we have a tourism and health administrations. Then we also try to provide the access through radio, web radio, which we have called Mukt Vidya Vani. And this Mukt Vidya Vani runs every day, and from 2 p.m. to 4:30 p.m., where the learners can ask the counselor who is on the radio, web radio, internet radio, through which the course material and the counselors are available for providing them the academic support to all learners. Then audio and video programs are also available on YouTube, as well as it's also available on our website, many of the programs which we have developed for the learners, which is also sent in terms of CDs. So various kind of channels are being used for providing the access to them. Then we have the other services in terms of when they come for the evaluation, the hall ticket and intimation cards are also available. They download it and then they visit to the examination center for appearing in the examinations. After the examination, it's the results also, which is also available on our website, and complete results in terms of marks statement and certificates are available on our website. They download it before it is reached to them, the physical certificate, and this certificate on the web is all equivalent for the purpose of further education. Then student information section, which we have provided at our website, which takes care of each and every byte of information of a particular student in terms of admission, in terms of examination, in terms of study, in terms of academic support. All information of each student are available through student information centers. Then on-demand examination is a unique system of examination which NIOS has started, whereby the learners can register for examination on the basis of their own preparation, and they can select the dates as per their own choice. This is a very nice system which we are having all 365 days, and the learners can register, take the dates and appear for the examination. In all our regional centers, it is available and monitored through a webcam at the headquarter in NIOS. Over, sir. We also did the assessment and certification of NEO Literates, which is a Government of India project under National Literacy Mission Authority, whereby we have done the assessment of 2 crores of adult learners for basic literacy. This we have done. And this is the certificate we provided to each learners. And last but not the least, it has happened, sir, the Learner Support Center, which we also call it Vidyarthi Call Center, where the online support to learners and other users are provided through a toll-free number. This is 1-800-180-9393. You can try and get all kinds of information under this. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Any quick questions?
Question about the payment. There was a site which showed credit card payment. Are we looking at?
Okay. My name is Biplab Sahab. I run a rural BPO in Uttarakhand. I have a question on the payment. Have you developed alternative mechanisms?
Yes.
For
you
payment?
You can pay. This is one of online payment I told you. Otherwise, you can make payment through credit card, through cash chalan, everything.
Are they at the, you know, what, can you do it at your block level or at the panchayat level, or do you have to come to us, or do you have to post a check?
You can send it through post. Or we have our own study center where you can submit your application with demand draft. Or you can submit at the common service center. We have also associated with common service center which are available at the village level. And the learners can go there, they will help, they become our facilitation center. They are all facilitation center, all 5,000 study centers we have all over India. They are facilitation center where learners can go and they get their online admission done there only. And they make the payment. Even the study center, they make payment online and they take the money from the learners. So that way it becomes very online. Even if a student who does not have an internet access, they can send, download the, get the admission forms either from the study center or from the facilitation center. They can send it to study center after filling it up, attaching the required document and the payment demand draft. And at the study center or at the regional centers, the entire offline admission is converted into online. So the alternative mode of payment is also available, all payments.
Both online and offline payment?
Yes, sir.
For every step of the way, that's available.
Yes.
So your medium of instruction is
online? It's a Hindi, English, and a regional medium. For secondary, we have 7 regional mediums. And for senior secondary, we have 3, Urdu.
Okay, and what is the medium, what is the language of your website? It's multilingual or only?
Bilingual, sir.
Bi means Hindi and English?
Hindi and English.
But since you need to penetrate to the rural area,
right, sir.
Maybe majority of the people are well-versed with only local language, then your at least your admission process, your registration form should be in the local language.
We are trying to do that, but what is happening that the other problems with the language, so we are associating with the local people over there through common service center. That is what I said.
So some mediator has to
be there. Yes, it's already there. Common service center is it has been established. It's through e-governance plan of Government of India. And
no, that is okay. Common service centers are there across the country.
Yes.
You are functioning, you are not functioning.
Yes.
So,
I think if you want to continue, you can go offline and talk because we have many other presentations.
A lot of presentations actually. Yeah. Sorry, yeah. So if you don't mind, other questions can be taken offline. Yeah. So thank you very much for that.
Thank you.
Next, we have CLTE Partnership.